Everybody has a hard time with his last name. I do too. And Carter Russo back there in the 21 machine. Carter's been working hard on that race car.
Almost. Carter Russo, another one of those young drivers that we love so much. He's had some quality finishes this year. He's a couple sixth place finishes, a second and a third. He would love to climb up that podium one more step and get a win under his belt. Jason Myers looks like he is just really setting sail, though.
Still side by side. Barnes gets a little bit of advantage, but a lot of momentum coming on the top side.
Unpack what happened. It looks like it's going to put Kyle Barnes in a very advantageous situation as our leader now. Here comes a replay for the Flow Racing fans. And it looked like Barnes just got side by side with Jason Myers.
Not sure if they touched wheels there because the camera shot was right there on them, so we couldn't see if there was any contact between them.
Turn four, and it will be win number four for Double Zero. The man from Draper, Virginia, gets it done again. A great restart after some contact with him out there. Love seeing that Danville Toyota pace car go into pit road. That means we are ready here in Southside Disposal. Pure Stocks action. Johnny Lane leads him off. Ooh, the Andrea Rutolo, that car with the special wrap, got real wide going into turn one. But he's stabilized and he's okay. It does allow, it looks like, the number two car of Jared Milam to sneak up into third place, but behind Phillips and Lane. Fourth. Zach Reeves, I think, just one race under his belt this season in this division, so good to see him back for another week in that red and black paint scheme there on the number 77 machine. Scott Phillips is leading. He doesn't have any wins, but his worst finish this season is third place. He's been in second or third all year long, and we have a crash. We have action. Trying to figure out what happened. Our first caution is out in the Southside Disposal Pure Stocks race. We're 18 laps into a 25-lap trip, so we'll step aside for a moment here. 60-second break on Flow Racing, and you're home for the 80s, 90s, and more. It's HLF. Flies for the nine car of Johnny Lane, his third win in the Southside Disposal Pure Stocks division. Scott Phillips second, Jared Milam third, Redmond fourth, Wade fifth.
Right, now, here we go, Talladega racing with the champ cars. These are actually go-karts that are on the racetrack now, folks.
They're go-karts, but they really zip around. I mean, they put together some really good times. Tyler Ray is the pole sitter. He was excited to be there, and man, they can handle differently too. They can get down on that apron, they can use the entire track dock, and there is so many of them out there. It is a crowded field. We're going to try our best to identify most of them. The herd, the gaggle, and the flock over there. And there's not as much drafting as there is. I think they're trying to pass in that big group, and we've got more contact in turn one. It's Jacob Thigpen. Jacob Tingen. We've got to get these last names work together on this one, Doc. We got to work together.
I'm not the only one that gets tongue-tied.
No, you're not, but I'm just trying to go through the last names here, and we do apologize to anybody whose last name that we mess up. I've got a strange spelling. Oh, racing fans are getting a replay anyway. If you're watching at the track, we're so glad that you're hanging out with us. If you're a racing fan, you got to check out Flow Racing. There was some contact there. That was the old bump and run move from behind in the moves well below the yellow line. They were practically going down pit road. What a finish there. Photo finish at the end in our champ carts. Excellent stuff. Pit road, they're ready to rev the engines and let it fly here in the Hornets division. Jared Dawson leading them off up front. Jason DiCarlo beside. How about Dylan Davis trying to sneak in there for second already? He's on the inside line, and looks like he does have a hold of second place for the moment, but DiCarlo going to come sweeping in from the outside in that blue car. They're chasing the 0-1 of Jared Dawson. He will be your first lap leader as they get across the start-finish line.
And moving, but definitely not what he had in that first lap.
Jared Dawson's got plenty of speed. He's up front at the moment, leading Dylan Davis, not far behind, trying to stalk him down as they get across the start-finish line one more time. They're into turn one clean. Good restart as he gets below the yellow line in turn one. He's out of turn two in the back straightaway as your leader. Side by side in a battle for the second spot, Kendall Milam and Dylan Davis.
The 07 and the 28 machine got together on the back straightaway and got that rear bumper, try to get him loose, get him out of position. And he's finally, it took him a lap,
going
to go for the lead now on the bottom side, door to door, going down the back straightaway.
It looks like Jared Dawson has enough to hold him off for the moment, but Dylan Davis is inside. He's on the apron, and he's got the lead. He will be in front as they cross the start-finish line. New leader there was Dylan Davis. Davis is up above Jared Dawson. Now on Jared Dawson in second. They are not going to catch number 63, Dylan Davis. He's had a pair of second-place finishes. Now he's got a win in the Hornet. Pace car is out of the way. They're on the dance floor and ready to rock and roll in a late model 100. There goes Jacob Horst and Landon Pembleton up front. Sparks flying early here as they get into turn two and on the back straightaway. Plenty of speed for Horst. How about Peyton Sellers? He's side by side, locked in a battle with Chris Denny for that third spot. They are really rolling now. Peyton Sellers will surge in front for third. He's behind Landon Pembleton, who's in second at the moment. Jacob Horst, a full two car lengths now, advantage in front of Pembleton. He loves racing here. He's going to do it for as long as he can. They are flying around the 0.4 mile ring here at South Boston Speedway. They're all chasing the 25 car of Jacob Horst. Horst is putting together some really good lap times already.
So is he going to start working over Camden Gully? He's not riding. A little bit of contact as they drop off in three and four. They get up door to door coming off of four.
Side by side across the start-finish line, that's Cam Gully and Lane Riggs. Riggs should have enough to overtake Gully. Yeah, Stacy Puryear lost the shape a little bit there. Turns three and four, and now we've got contact. Sideways there, coming out of turn two. Car of Aaron Donnelly, that was a part of it. Let's see who the second car was here. They get into turn one clean, and then it's 31 Donnelly with the right front into the left rear of Stacy Puryear. And then the car that got caught up in the mess there was number two, Chris Denny. Denny was following behind. He had to hold off the hard-charging Lane Riggs. Riggs sweeping around to the top side, and he lost it. He lost it. He's into the wall. A couple spins for Lane Riggs.
They've got a right rear tire. I wonder if he made contact with Pembleton. Because look at the spot on the replay. Look at the sparks right here. Yep, see, there's sparks. It keeps sparking. I think he had a tire right rear. Yeah, left rear was down.
Wow. What a break there. A bad break for Lane Riggs. Let it ride through the south side disposal restart zone. It's Peyton Sellers in the orange and white Danville Toyota car. Takes that lead again. No problem. Surging in front of Landon Pembleton. Mostly double file behind or double stack behind Pembleton, and we've got damage again. We've got a collision again there in between turn three and four.
A couple of times. This is not going to, it's got to get his pulse rating up.
Another great replay from our Flow Racing crew.
That lead.
Double file, side-by-side restart coming up here. They're into the south side disposal restart zone. The fans are on their feet. Green flag flying. Peyton Sellers, your leader. Oh, and look at Jacob Horst. He tried to get the back bumper into him, I think, and then he chose to go outside here. They're into turns three and four. That was that Bermuda Triangle early, but it looks like we got through there clean. White flag in the air. Peyton Sellers in front, looking for win number two this season. He's going to have to hold off a hard-charging Jacob Horst. Horst surging ahead on the outside. Sellers is inside. He'll try to hold him off. They're coming out of turn four. Contact there, collision, door-to-door. Photo finish again, and it was Jacob Horst. Horst edged him by a nose.
Jacob, what a comeback. Do you feel that this is one of the best drives of your young career?
Yeah, it definitely is. That was definitely my best win. You know, you're battling a national champion, and if I was on the inside of him, I would have done the same thing. So
we really did need to go to the replay to figure out that Scott Heath won that kart race. Green flag time again here in the Budweiser Limited Sportsman 30-lap trip. It's Myers and Dawson battling up front, side by side, one and two. Not much of an edge there on the start for Jason Myers. In fact, number 17 might have to give up the lead to the 88 car. They'll cross the start-finish line, and it is a new leader. Justin Dawson, your lap one leader, as he surges by Jason Myers. Let's go back and look at his times from race number one, Doc, but I think we can say with pretty full confidence that his crew has made some adjustments for the top spot for a moment. Now Jason Myers coming out of turn four, surging in front of Justin Dawson. He's on the inside line, Dawson outside. I don't know that Dawson's going to have enough to take the lead back, but we'll see. Myers has got a good groove there. Left car in front of him. It's not going to matter, though. Nobody's going to get close enough to catch number 17, Jason Myers. Second victory of the season. Turn to South Boston Speedway, putting the finishing touches on what was an incredible night of racing.